Greetings, fellow YouTubers. I decided to go ahead and use some backlogged footage in place of my lack of activity for a while. I actually never intended on using this footage for anything, but it's of a few weeks ago when my grandparents and I went to this exhibit at our local historical center called Out of This World. And basically what it was is it was a bunch of costumes and props and different original memorabilia from different sci-fi series that people donated to the museum for the exhibit and put their own pieces on display. There, a quick wardrobe change. I figured I'm in black too much, and black's really kind of like downing and depressive. And this video that I recorded, as I said, wasn't really intended to be used for anything, so it's already gonna kind of be kind of immature to begin with and a little shaky, so maybe the bright colors will help some. Yeah.
Hi, Mama.
Hi.
Say hi.
Downtown Orlando.
I'm going, I guess we can.
Hello. How are you?
Hello.
Hello.
Hi.
Yes, random counter guy, you are so famous now. You are on YouTube. Welcome.
See a shirt? See a shirt?
Hello.
Oh, what's here, Chris?
Oh, yeah, I definitely. Oh, they have tribbles? I just ordered one of those. I paid cheaper than that on eBay. Yeah, but there's no guarantee on eBay. I want the Enterprise. If I get anything, I'd get the Enterprise. One of the Enterprises. No, I didn't. I had a Plexi model. God, I'd love to get that one. Wow.
The one random guy that pointed out my shirt was really cool. He was kind of like an old school Trekkie, and he was trying to bring his kids and hoping that his little kids would be interested in it and understanding what was going on. But of course, they were just completely pointless. Like, they knew some terminology, and I was impressed with that. But other than that, they really didn't know anything. The guy talked with me about Enterprise and how he thought it should have gone on longer, but they did do some things that were a little off that they could have done better on it to make the series more likable towards the original fans, and I agreed with him on a few points and disagreed on others. But he pointed out my shirt because the kids actually knew what a classic phaser looked like, which I thought was amazing. Because most people just hear the terminology, and if they see the shirt, they don't get it. But the shirt says, set phasers to stun. I think I got it at Stephen Barry's just before they closed. But yeah, that guy was cool. I'll remember him.
Hang on, I'll do that in a minute. You've been transported out of this world. Hang on, I want to look at all this. Oh crap, they even did up the elevator. That is great.
So when I'd actually gotten to the exhibit part of the exhibit, they had actually stopped me. They called security and stopped me and asked me to no longer film because apparently a lot of the memorabilia there is old and exposure to light and flash photography isn't good for the fabric. Something about it can degrade it or that, plus there's copyright issues too there. So I respected that and stopped filming. One, just out of general respect, because I wouldn't want my work filmed if somebody else didn't want it filmed either. And two, because I really didn't feel like getting jumped by a bodyguard. Yeah, I'm not into handcuffs type things, bondage, no, sorry, not me. But what they did have there, I can tell you about. They, one of the cool things they had was Jeri Ryan's, outfit, the blue one, that she wore in Star Trek Voyager. They had a few of the spacesuits from Star Trek as well. They had a few things from The Wizard of Oz, like the witch's hat. They had a few outfits from Battlestar Galactica. They had Jean-Luc Picard's original uniform from the first season of The Next Generation. I thought that was amazing. I really wanted to touch it, but of course it was in like 3-inch thick glass on this nice big display case, and you couldn't smudge a display case. They also had a... the hero models of different ships used in Star Trek movies and the series. Like, they had a couple Klingon battle cruisers that were in there, and they were maybe half the length of my body, maybe the length of my arm, but they were amazing, the detail on those things. I think they were all done by ILM, which is Industrial Light and Magic, but yeah, they were amazing. Overall, I really had expected a lot more out of something called Out of This World. But it was really great just that somebody had dedicated all of this memorabilia that they had to a one-off exhibit that'll hopefully be an annual thing, because I'd really like to go again. Some things I'm going to be doing later. I'm going to record random outings. Like, I've already started recording things for another post I'm going to do, which is my just randomly driving around to different places and recording. The collaboration thing with my best friend eventually, if he ever gets on his webcam, and we'll do that. I want to talk about different TV shows like Star Trek, Smallville, The Birds of Prey, little things like that that I like. They're more specific types, and it's either you like it, you don't. But I really think that there's a lot to talk about there, and maybe eventually I'll talk about the book series I'm working on, because I'm really passionate about that. Currently I have 7 books planned in it. So we'll see. Bye, kids.